Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining me. There's been so much bullshit. Okay, I'll just come out and say that. Bullshit about what's going on there on La Palma with the volcano. It's hard to keep up with the magnitude of earthquakes because they have been downgrading them greatly. Here we got a current view of the volcano. The cone has collapsed several times. There has been several earthquakes, large earthquakes, and they are warning the people there on the island that larger earthquakes will come, in fact. This one earthquake was actually probably a magnitude 4.8 that was downgraded to a 4.6. The day before, there was a magnitude 4.9, which was probably actually a 5.1. The 4.6 was felt across three different islands. That's another reason why I say it was probably much larger. It was felt in La Gomera, it was felt in Tenerife, and it was also reportedly felt in El Hierro. Some of the felt reports on EMSC said it woke them up because of the earthquake. Another one says it was very strong shaking. That was Las Lomas, sorry, getting a little tongue-tied there. And another one says it was very long and a lot of movement. A local radio station has resorted into reporting the news because, according to them, and we all know this, they are saying that most media corporations have not treated the volcanic eruption as news. So a local radio station has started publishing their own webpage. This webpage has been translated to doing their own reports for the people there of La Palma. All right, so here's the location of today's 4.8. And up over here was the 4.6 also occurring today. Only one felt report so far on EMSC. It says strong shaking and durable. Now, that one was just a little while ago, and people are saying it was probably actually a 5.1. Shortly before that 4.8, there was a magnitude 4.5. These are very deep. This is coming from the mantle of the Earth. One of the reports from one of the stations there showing a lava bomb, showing that, in fact, this magma is coming up from the mantle of the Earth because in the center of this lava bomb is crystals, whereas the outside of the lava bomb, when it landed and cooled, encased on the outside from older lava that had already cooled. These are crystals, is what's called earth-forming minerals that crystallize before the lava erupted. Within it is also volcanic glass. Comes from the upper mantle of the Earth, right there. The upper mantle of the Earth. The upper layer, the upper mantle of the Earth is a very thick layer of rock inside the planet, which begins just beneath the crust of the Earth, showing you how deep this magma is coming up from. It's not from a magma chamber, it is coming up from below the crust of the Earth. Here's another image. Number one is the continental crust. Number two, the oceanic crust. Number three, the upper mantle. Number four, the lower mantle. So this hot magma is coming deep within the Earth. That is very significant. This volcano is not going to end its eruption anytime soon. They are now saying that the eruption will probably last at least 5 months. I think they're underestimating the time frame of this eruption. I think it's going to last longer than 5 months. At last count, there was 138 earthquakes within a 24-hour period, but I'm sure it's larger now. Maybe closer to 140 within the last 24 hours. Here's an image from yesterday of one of those earthquakes and the hot lava that came up with it. Here's an image of what it's currently showing. Let me go back an hour. Oh, it won't let me do that. It'll only let me go back one day. All right, let me try something else. All right, this was between 1700 and 1800 hours. And we'll go forward another hour, 18 and 19. And 19 and 20. Now this is universal time. 20 and 21. There's another earthquake right there. Between 21 and 22 hours universal time. 23 and 22. 23 and 24, you can see. Yeah, look at the heat that came up with that earthquake. That would probably be the 4.7 earthquake. And then we got between midnight and 1 o'clock universal. 1 and 2 universal time. 2 and 3 universal. This one here would probably be a 3.4, the larger one. Between 3 and 4 universal. Between 4 and 5 universal. Between 5 and 6 universal. This one here is probably the 3.8 earthquake. Between 6 and 7 universal. That would probably be the 4.6 earthquake. Between 7 and 8. Between 8 and 9. Between 9 and 10 and universal. 10 and 11 universal. Now this is today. 11 and a 12. 12 and 13. 13, 14 universal. 14 and 15 universal. There is one definitely very significant and another one and possibly another one. So the first one's probably a 4.8. And that's all they're showing so far. So the next one would be a 3.7 and then the last one would be a 3.1. And that brings it up to as of 10:11 Central Daylight Time as I'm making this video. So they claim that the volcano in deformation is going down. Well, yeah, after its collapse, it went down. It was all the way up to, oh, close to 320 millimeters, which is about 12 inches of uplift. And it went down to a little more than 200 millimeters. Let me bring this over. Let me go back down here. Okay. So we got 200 millimeters. So that's about 8 inches in height. So it dropped since yesterday, maybe about 4 inches after the multiple collapses of the cone. But here you can see how quickly it rose from 120 millimeters. That's what that little dot is right there. Let me bring it over. 120 millimeters. It jumped to 320 millimeters in just one day. So it jumped from 4.7 inches of uplift to 12.6 inches of uplift, nearly doubling in height in just a matter of hours. Doubling in height. And then we had the collapse, and who knows what's currently going on. That is from that monitor right there. The northern part of the island, the deformation is holding steady. But on the southern part, and I'll go to this one right here, yeah, there's been uplift, and it went down. Let me show you. We'll bring it over. So we got 1.6 inches of uplift right here. But see, the previous history, it was actually minus. See that? Minus, 40 millimeter. And you can see after the eruption, it rose up and it still hasn't gone down. Slight decrease today at the southern end of the monitor. And then at the farthest end of the monitor, we'll go to that one, farthest end of the island. It's been holding pretty steady. So most of the movement of the island has been this small area right here. Now at the northern end of the island, going back to Google Earth, basically all the crops have been destroyed by the ash. I believe this is cabbage that they are growing there. And this is from the northern end. This is a still from a clip. Let me bring this over so you can see the location. Right up there, they got a little green dot. They have to take all the crops to the dump. They're throwing them all away because of the damage from the ash. The man was showing what I believe is mangoes, and he was pointing out how the ash had damaged the mangoes, and as he was touching it, you know, it literally fell off the vine. So here they were picking lettuce, tipped it upside down. I don't know if you can see the lettuce there as they were shaking it, and showing all the ash that was in the plant. The northern part where they were showing the crops that had to be thrown out was 30 kilometers or 19 miles. Here's another still showing the ash there in La Palma, La Loma, I believe this is. Lava had flowed all the way up to where this wall is. And you can see the heated water, steam coming up from the sewer vents. And then yesterday there was landslides that actually closed off roads so people couldn't go in to shovel off their roofs or retrieve their possessions. Some of the images of the lava as they flowed around, mostly because they had retaining walls built that kind of rechanneled the lava. I noticed here this was as tall as at least one story tall, the magma. And here's another image of the roofs, yeah, and the ash. Another image from this news video trying to shovel off the ash from these roofs. I mean, look how deep it is. And you can see the ash and the gas has killed off all the plant life. As I stated before, they only have about an hour and a half time to get in and shovel this ash off. And you can see how thick it is here. And Las Lomas, where it's going into, I talked about the apartment buildings. You know, where people are going to lose everything. There is one road off to the left. And this road here is still open if they can come up through the back, possibly, and retrieve their belongings. And another image as it makes its way, this new finger of lava makes its way to the ocean. And another image of the eruption, just when one of the sides of the cone was collapsing. And another image, supposedly as of right now, 2,164 buildings have been destroyed, most of those homes. 124 are damaged. So we got 2,164 destroyed plus 124 damaged. Supposedly 808 hectares of lava, or about 22,260 acres of lava, have flowed out of this volcano. And another image when the volcano collapsed. And they talked about the exotic pets they were taking here on the northern part of the island, right there where that little green dot is. All the birds and turtles and guinea pigs and whatnots. They were really concerned about the birds being crushed in transportation. And we're saying how they were taking in these pets, these animals, there on the northern part of the island. Next week, they're going to hold a meeting for the final approval for the $14 million that they're going to distribute for losses for properties and crops. That won't be held until next week. So the money still hasn't been distributed. Aid has now been expanded to those that are considered self-employed. They're going to get approximately 1,000 euros, which is about $1,161 a month for the next 5 months. And they will collect these benefits until February 28th. That's where it stands now. And they want a road built from the coast that has cut off many of those little villages. In the meantime, they're asking the mayors to provide boat transportation so the people can still get into the banana plantations and their homes so they can work, because the main road has been completely cut off. But they realize that building a road is expensive and it's going to take a long time. So they're asking the mayors to provide boat transportation to get into that. The ash from the volcano and the gases is rising 3,400 meters or 11,200 feet. The plume, lava bombs, is going, I guess, in the smoke, 2,000 meters or 6,600 feet. The air quality for today and predicted for tomorrow is very, very poor. And they're saying that the sulfur dioxide is very high. I'll give you links to all these different articles. There was a landslide Monday in Ardan Valley. Like I said, it cut off people from getting into their homes and apartments to collect their belongings. Yeah, very bad situation. And they also said, which was really interesting, that the eruptions there at the volcano increase at night. Remember I was telling you, those that follow me, that for some reason large earthquakes always seem to, or mostly happen at night? Well, this volcano, its eruptions, they have noticed, increase at night. The lava flow increase at night. Their earthquakes increase at night, which is something that they're probably looking into to find out why that is happening. But the white here that you see on this live feed from TV Canary, that is gases. Those are gases. And the black is ash. And then we got gases exploding, throwing up the lava bombs and things like that. But so a lot of people can get confused. What's the white? Well, the white is gases, sulfur dioxide, CO2, carbon monoxide, etc. And the black is ash. And every so often you can see a lava bomb being shot up. And they're saying that it's probably going to be erupting for another 5 months. But their unemployment evidently is only going through February 28th of next year. So that's all I have for you right now. If you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you very much for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. I'm also on Patreon. If you want to support my work, please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.